Good afternoon. Welcome to St. Peter Paul the Apostles Church. All parish offices will be closed this Monday, September 4th, in observance of Labor Day. The 11 a.m. daily mass will be celebrated in the chapel. Our youth group kicks off this Sunday, September 3rd, at 6 p.m. here at Monsignor Moretti Center. Teens ages 14 to 18 are invited for pizza and fun. So spread the word, invite a friend, and join us. Many of our activities, such as Catholic Women's Bible Study, WOW, Catholic Women's Association, and Grief Ministry, will be resuming in the next few days and weeks. For more information on these and other parish activities, please take home a bulletin or visit our website. Out of respect for the Eucharist, please turn off all cell phones and electronic devices.
Let us gather together singing, "The God of All Grace." Please stand.
Thank you. pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. The Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were too strong for me, and you triumphed. All the day I am an object of laughter. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day. I say to myself, I will not mention him. I will speak his name no more. But then it becomes like fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary holding it in. I cannot endure it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Whoever wishes to come after me, deny himself, take up his cross and follow me. Whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. Whoever loses his life on the sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? The Son of Man will come with his angels and his Father's glory, and then he will reveal all according to his conduct. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The transformative journey is embracing the cross and denying oneself. The transformative journey is embracing the cross and denying oneself. When you take today's gospel and pick up a few important words, for me, five words stand out. One is cross. Second is suffering. Third, Jerusalem. Fourth, obstacles. And the fifth, denying oneself. Let's see. Jesus was last week in Caesarea Philippi and asked Peter, "Whom do you say I am?" And he said, "You are the Son of the living God." And today's gospel, Jesus in up north is looking down south Jerusalem and says, "I have to go and suffer," and he predicts his passion. And the same Peter who said, "You are the Son of the living God," says, "It shouldn't happen to you." And Jesus said last week, "On the rock in which I built my church," and this week he says, "You rock are Satan, an obstacle. Get behind." Look at this passage from Matthew's Gospel. It has the Peter's profession in chapter 16, and the following is chapter 17, is the experience of transfiguration. In between, what happens is Jesus is trying to prove the apostles that his purpose on earth, his journey, is not to run a government or a kingdom, but rather to do the will of God. The whole cross is his focus. It means for his suffering. Very many times, it's very difficult for us to understand in our life. Nobody here, I believe, wants to suffer. But we know what happened in this last week. We all faced that in Italia, and people lost houses, and people lived in the panhandle, Tallahassee, and people, branches were out, the power was out. Some type of suffering in any human transaction. Same thing with the forest fire. Same thing, economic turmoils, sickness, breaking in relationship. We all suffer. Suffering is inevitable. Nobody can avoid suffering. But we can journey the suffering when we put in the same platform, suffering and cross. Today, people don't want to suffer because for them, everything should be super good. Everything should be perfect world. For us Christians, after suffering comes glory. Jesus talks about not just death alone. He's sad to die. He talks about death in terms of resurrection. For him, it is humiliation leads to glory. Once a husband was getting ready to church, looking at the mirror and asked his wife, "Honey, help me out. Look at me, I'm looking at the mirror. My hair is gray. My skin is becoming saggy. Look at my chin. And my tummy is becoming bigger and hip is becoming bigger. Can you say a nice word? An uplifting word. And then cheer me up. Let me listen to your words." And she said, "Honey, you have an excellent eyesight." Peter was not giving an uplifting word to Jesus. He said, "Forbid, this should not happen to you." How many times in our own family we create words that come out of mouth? It's not uplifting. It pulls the people down. But it doesn't mean to say we have to run away from these toxic people. The toxic people will be there, problems will be there, suffering will be there, but the journey continues because it's transformative. We look the journey because God walks with us. He said, "Don't give up. I'm going to transfigure. I did the healing. I am in the ministry. I'm going towards Jerusalem. When you walk with me, there is a denial that comes from the power of God." Therefore, the word I said, obstacles. We face obstacles in our Christian life. There's so many obstacles. Psychological, mental, emotional. As years go by, sometimes you feel God is not in tune with you, talking to you. But good news for us. Want to be by his disciple, take up your cross and follow. That is a commitment that when Jesus called the disciples to be a cast of being a disciple demands. Walking towards the cross, suffering is part of life. The Jerusalem, a place of suffering, which become glory, and we face obstacles when we deny ourselves and look up the cross and follow him. There is salvation, there is peace. We say very often in one of the mysteries of faith that the cross of shame be the cross of glory in our lives. As we pray in one of the mysteries of faith, we say, "Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free." I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, We seek God's understanding and love as we humbly offer our prayers of supplication.
That the church will serve as a model, leading us to take up Christ's cross, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For civil servants who strive to end racial inequity and violence, may local leaders lead efforts toward reconciliation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That students and teachers returning to school will approach their challenges with a love of learning, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those affected by Hurricane Idalia and the Maui fires, may receive swift aid and know the comfort of our prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our servicemen and women serving in all parts of the world, first responders, police, firefighters, and medical personnel, that they may enjoy God's protection, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who gather here will find strength and support in this caring and loving community of believers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, hospitalized, and homebound of our community, and for all those written in our parish intention books, that their hearts be filled with peace and hope, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, especially the deceased of Saints Peter and Paul the Apostles, as well as the living members, as well as Veronica Fury and Alice Norris, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silent prayer, let us offer God the needs of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, it's the honor and ability to fathom your infinite kindness. Hear this prayer that we earnestly offer. We ask this with Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us, O Lord, the blessing of salvation, that what is celebrated in mystery may accomplish in power. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. Through Christ our Lord, by his birth, he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state. The suffering cancelled out our sins, by his rising from the dead. He has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to your Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end, we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Thou mayst talk me your faith.
Sisters of fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who died in your mercy. Welcome in light of your face and mercy, as all we pray. The Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, as first Blessed Apostles, and Francis, and Blessed Anthony, and Peter, and Paul, John of the Cross, and the rest, and all the saints who bless you to all the ages, and merit to be has eternal life. And the praise and glory for you to your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him, one in him. O God Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and
free from sin and save all distress, as we await blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, your Savior, pastors, peace, I live in my peace, I give you. Look on in our sins the faith of the Church. Graciously grant the peace and unity according to the world, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
It is of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
So for each other, the sign of peace.
Thank you. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Father.
Thank you for being with us today. You know the old saying, no news is good news? Well, there's no news. Just keep praying. I thought we had published in here, I kind of looked at the collection for Hawaii. It's not in here, okay. It was a very, very generous response. I don't have the numbers offhand, but I saw a very generous response last weekend for the collection for those affected by the fires in Hawaii. And I would just like to say thank you for that generous outpouring. We will let you know the number. I think there were still some things coming in, so that might be part of the reason we don't have it in here yet. But thank you for that loving act of support to help people who are in crisis. Almost certainly now, if we've, in gratitude to Almighty God, we need to look into the fact that we were spared this storm, but we had to see the places to the north, and almost certainly they will ask for another collection at some point. So thank you in advance for your generosity. This parish has been tremendous in the outpouring of generosity and support during these terrible tragedies that have affected the community. Thank you in advance for that. And part of it is just the prayer of thanksgiving and our offering to say that we were spared. And for that, we are truly, truly grateful. We pray that you have a good week and a good Labor Day weekend. This is the last official weekend of the summer, they tell us, but it'll still be 90 degrees next week. So enjoy this last weekend. You won't see me for a couple of weeks. Father Paul's in charge. I'm going on vacation. And I'm going to some place that will be cool. I'll be around here. So you'll see me back about the 20th of September. So you have a good couple of weeks. And again, thank you for being with us.
Let us pray. Renewed by this bread in the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, to be the fruit of charity, and to confirm our hearts and stir us to serve in the neighbor. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go in peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Receive.
Thanks be to God.
Let us go forth singing, O bless the Lord.